Hello beauties, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dana Waldy, licensed esthetician and makeup artist, and I'm actually super excited to shoot this video today. I think out of all my videos that I've ever done, this is gonna end up being my favorite one because I really feel it's gonna provide the most value to you. Well, hopefully it does. So after watching this, if you found some value in this video, please make sure to drop me a comment below. I wanna hear from you. I wanna hear if this is something you're already doing, using, loving. So without further ado, let's hop right in. We're in my kitchen, and this is called castor oil packing. And for those of you who aren't familiar with castor oil is a very unique oil. There's so many benefits with castor oil, but today I'm going to show you how to do a castor oil pack. So first, let's talk about some of the benefits of castor oil. So castor oil is a very unique vegetable oil. It's very molecular dense. So with that being said, it has the ability to penetrate through our epidermis, which is the top layer of our skin, right down into the dermis. So once it's down there, it has this ability to start really detoxifying our cells, our lymphatic drainage, and have a very serious effect on our organs. So castor oil packing is really meant to do around your abdomen, your liver area, or you can do it around your breast area. So some of the benefits and way the castor oil pack is used, it's for those who maybe have dense tissue in their breast area, who suffer from like fibroids, polyps for women in the ovaries. It helps to really break down the cysts and fibroids. It helps with fatty liver or people who have really active enzymes. You know, for me right now, we're in quarantine mode, so I've been definitely drinking more wine than usual. So this is gonna come in handy for me today to do a nice little liver detox. So before I jump in to show you how to make the castor oil pack, some things to know is definitely not do this if you are menstruating. It is definitely too active in the ovary area and certainly not when you're pregnant. Just a reminder, I am an esthetician. I am not a doctor. This is just something I'm sharing that has worked for me. I've done a lot of research online. There's a lot of doctors who tout this and do it themselves and recommend it to their patients. So I wanted to share this, and I didn't think it was coincidence. Just to give you my own personal story, I suffered from fibroistic tumors in both breasts when I was 16. One was the size of a golf ball that I actually had to have removed. In my adult years, they have come back. I've gotten them biopsied. Thankfully, you know, they're non-cancerous, so thank goodness, but I do have to monitor them and I have to get ultrasounds every 6 months to make sure they do not get larger in size. Since I've started doing the castor oil packing around the breast area, I don't know if this is coincidence or not, but I've actually reduced the size in one of them by almost 1 centimeter, which is a pretty big deal. So I don't know, to me the proof is in the pudding. I actually have to track them every 6 months. I go to the hospital and I get ultrasounds. So I don't know, I had to share this with you because I think it's pretty incredible. This is something that you can do up to about 3 times a week. So let's hop right in. I'm gonna go over some of the supplies that you will need for this. You're definitely gonna need some castor oil. You're gonna need a wool flannel. You can order these on Amazon. I'll put links below to where you can purchase everything. You're gonna need a pair of scissors. I use an ACE bandage, we'll get into why. A heating pad. And then a glass container. I make the actual pack in a glass container. The reason you wanna do it in glass is because the castor oil can actually absorb the plastic. And once I'm done with the pack, I just keep it right in this container and I store it in the refrigerator. It's also easier to clean up when you do it in glass. Or when you take out the wool flannel from the pack, it's gonna be large. And so you actually wanna cut this so that it fits around here. I'm using a brand new one. You get about 20 uses out of this and then you wanna toss it and then start a fresh one. So I'm starting with a fresh one. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it right in down the center so that it wraps around my abdomen, my liver, my lower abdomen down here. It's gonna fit my body just like this. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this in half. There we go, I have it fitting perfectly. I cut it in half. Now we're gonna take the wool flannel. You're gonna put it in your glass dish And we are essentially just going to saturate this entire wool flannel with the castor oil. So you can see how saturated this is. I'm just pouring every last drop of my castor oil out into the dish here. Like I said, this oil is really, really molecular dense. It is very heavy, oily, kind of greasing on your skin. So I actually like to use a pair of tongs to just really get this all saturated in my dish, in my nice glass container here. I swish it around. I make sure the oil is just everywhere and saturated. Okay, once this is all mixed up, I just take my lid, I set it right on top because we're gonna go right into the next step. Okay, now that we have our wool cloth all nice and saturated, I keep it in my container with the lid on. We are gonna hop into my bedroom because that is where I go to relax with my castor oil pack. So we're gonna take the saturated wool, we're gonna take the heating pad in there and your ACE bandage. I take my tongs and I also prep my bed, which you'll see, with a towel. I lay down an old towel. I don't care if it gets oily or messed up. I'm usually in my comfy clothes, some nice stretch pants on because we're gonna have to wrap this around our belly. So let's hop into the bedroom. Okay, so here we are in my bedroom. We are nice and cozy. I have my bed prepped with all the supplies we'll need. So as I mentioned, I prep my bed where over the top of my comforter, I put a towel down. I typically use a towel that I don't necessarily care about in case any oil gets on there. I have a smaller hand towel, which I will actually wrap into the bottom of my pants. We have our ACE bandage. We have our heating pad that's been warming up in here. And then of course we have our castor oil pack. So it's in that glass Pyrex dish. I brought my tongs in with me because I used the tongs to pull out the castor oil pack because it is saturated with oil. So what I'm gonna do before we even hop into that, I'm gonna take the small hand towel, I'm gonna tuck it into the bottom of my pants. I am definitely taking one for the team. I don't love having to expose my belly with you all, but it's for the sake of the video. So what I do, I take this hand towel, again, it's one I don't really care about. I line the bottom of my pants with this so that no oil from the pack gets onto my clothing. And then I'm gonna go ahead, let me move this pillow so I don't get oil on there. I'm gonna take the oil pack. It is super duper saturated. Remember, I cut it down so it'll basically kind of fit the size of my abdomen. We're gonna cover the liver, we're gonna cover abdomen, down below, our lower belly. And I just put this all around. And it's pretty sticky with the oil. I always have my hair tied back, as you'll notice, otherwise my hair usually gets in the way. This is when we're gonna use our ACE bandage. I typically do this standing up, but I'm doing the best of my capabilities. I am the director here and cameraman, and my camera's on a tripod, so I'm just working with what I have. Typically, you would be standing up. We're gonna take the ACE bandage, and we are gonna, it's very difficult to do when you're sitting down, wrap around the body. I've seen a lot of videos where people take like saran wrap or like trash bags and all kinds of weird stuff. I definitely find the ACE bandage is the easiest to work with because you just wrap it on your body. I'm gonna tuck it in below. And this secures the oil pack on your belly. So once we have this all snug in place, I'm going to move myself to the side here so it's out of the way. I'm gonna prop myself up with a pillow so I can go ahead and get nice and cozy. For this to be effective, you really wanna do the oil pack on your belly for about 30 minutes, anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour. We're going to lay back and you will usually, or you will, not usually, you're gonna have residue of oil. I like to use this little hand towel on my legs here and I wipe off the excess residue. I'm now gonna take my heating pad, and this is really the packing part. So the heat is what really is going to drive the castor oil into the skin, really push it down into like the organs. It's working in the lymph. Again, this is all about detoxing. It helps with inflammation. It helps with, you know, this could help with sore muscles, certainly just from the heat itself. But this is working down into, you know, the dermis, into the organs. It's good to like detoxing for the liver area. You know, so many benefits. I know I went over this in the beginning of the video. I also do this actually on my breasts because of my fibrocystic tumors in my breast. So I'm usually doing the packing around the breast area, but we're certainly not doing that on camera. So I just kind of set myself up for success for this next 30 minutes to an hour. I take this time for myself to either catch up on reading. I keep a book handy. I have my laptop here with my kind of note-taking pad. This is usually the time when I sit and do research for my next videos. So I take the time to just do research for future YouTube videos. One key important thing is you always want to have something to drink handy. I usually always have water. And you're gonna start feeling a little dehydrated. Again, this is very, very detoxifying. So I actually take my water. I do about 80% water and the 20% I use like a naked juice to put in here just to help get some electrolytes flowing because you're gonna get really thirsty. You can certainly do tea or whatever your drink of choice is, but I do some nice water and juice combo if you wanna have snacks handy during this time. One thing I don't do is I do not keep my cell phone nearby because I don't want to be distracted with social media or urgent messages that come through. This is really my time to focus on me, maybe just relax. Perhaps I might take a little nap. Or like I said, this is when I catch up on reading. Today, I am going to do some research on some future videos. There's a couple things I want to do. So let's sit tight and get cozy. Okay, so that is it. I got to spend about 40 minutes just for some me time. I got to get some research done. As you can see, I've already disrobed. I didn't want to do that on camera, but I just take the castor oil pack. I put it back in my glass dish. I cover it with a container and I pop this in the fridge. I do this about 3 times a week. So at the end of each week is when I usually wash out my container. Of course, before you start your next packing session, you're going to need to resaturate it with the oil. Some people say to put it in a Ziploc bag. I definitely recommend doing a glass container so none of the plastic seeps into the castor oil pack itself. Because that castor oil, it's so molecular dense, it can pull in some of the plastic, and we certainly don't want that. So again, I just keep it in here. You're going to have a lot of the castor oil on your stomach area. So what I do is I just massage it into my stomach, usually around my back. There's going to be a lot, so there'll certainly be excess. That's when your little hand towel that's tucked in the bottom of your pants is going to come in handy. I use it to just pat down my stomach, wipe my hands off. And that is it. Super simple. I definitely want to hear if you've tried this. What are some other ways you're using castor oil? I know there's so many benefits of castor oil and so many different ways you can use it. I do have some other videos either coming up or I'm already planning on posting on castor oil, so I'll make sure to put those links below. All the products I use today, I will certainly put the links below in the description box. So if this is something you're interested in, please make sure to check that out. And of course, if you like this video, if you found some value from it, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more content like this, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you get notified every time I post a new video. And I can't wait to see you next time. Bye, beauties.